Cattails 7, I can't take him with me, she said. I can't get him out of the closet. He's a cat, not a wild mountain lion. You try it. The closet wasn't very big, just a garden variety recess in the wall with sliding doors that had a tendency to fall off the track and onto your head. I turned on the hall light to see into the back of the closet. Just as I caught sight of the furry shadow with glowing amber eyes in the far corner, the light went out. I jumped and screamed. Reflex. I told you so, Marla said. Does that always happen? I reached into a box and pulled out a light bulb. Wow. This box is full of light bulbs. I centered the step stool Marla brought me under the ceiling light, climbed up, and replaced the bulb, dropping the burned out bulb into Marla's hands. Every single time. She sighed. It's not scary really, just strange, and it's only this light. She slid the closet door shut. Mr. Hyde came with the apartment, and now he's yours. I wanted a pet, but I was thinking a kitten. You could still have a kitten, but Mr. Hyde stays. I glanced back at the closet. Does he ever come out of there? How do you feed him? Put the food out. He'll eat. Marla picked up the box of light bulbs and headed for the door. He prefers tender victuals. As if unable to make up her mind, Marla hesitated at the door, looked down at the box, and set it back down. You'll need these, she said, and left, leaving me with a cat. A black cat. I shook my head and smiled. Maybe he'd be like Shadow, who used to lie in front of the keyboard while I worked and sleep on the pillow next to me, when he wasn't stretched out across my neck, apparently unaware he was no longer a kitten and weighed half a ton. After unpacking the dishes and putting them away, I checked the refrigerator. Empty. I needed food, so did Mr. Hyde. Right, tender victuals. Maybe they were on sale. Over the next few days the food disappeared, but Mr. Hyde made not a single appearance. Three bulbs burned out before I stopped looking at the corner where the shadows were darkest and two large yellow orbs blinked up at me. Clearly, he wasn't starving, but I began to long for the feel of soft fur and the sound of contented purring. But Mr. Hyde evidently wasn't the kind of cat that slept on desks or pillows. I gave up trying to coax him out and enjoyed my new apartment with the fireplace in the bedroom. A week later, Mr. Hyde came out of the closet. I had just stretched the kinks out of my back and was settling in for two more hours of work. Just as I put on the headphones and settled my fingers on the keyboard, I jumped straight up out of my chair, with Mr. Hyde's claws firmly anchored to my backside. He dropped off and landed softly on the floor as I looked at the blood on my fingertips. He stared up at me, golden eyes all innocence, and meowed. He was coal black, without a single white hair anywhere, with eyes a rich, clear amber. He was beautiful. As I bent down to pet him, Mr. Hyde meowed again, got up, walked to the door, and stopped to look over his shoulder. He wanted me to follow him. I did. Right into the kitchen. His water bowl was empty, and only two pieces of kibble were left in his bowl. He sat down and waited, silently and patiently looking up at me. I obliged and filled his dishes. Mr. Hyde put out a paw and tipped over the bowl. He looked up at me. I filled the bowl, and he tipped it over again. I mopped up the water. Before I put down another bowl of water for him to spill, on a hunch I washed out the bowl, filled it, and set it back down. Mr. Hyde drank delicately and then tucked into his food. I was dismissed. Over the next few weeks, between sudden attacks of lancing claws in my backside and Mr. Hyde's yowls when I forgot he was lying behind my chair and slid back, catching his tail fur in the wheels, which was beginning to look quite bald in places, we settled into a comfortable working relationship. He even ventured to sleep at the foot of the bed on the unoccupied side, but wouldn't move any closer. For a year we rubbed along very comfortably, or at least he did, since I couldn't figure out how to sink my claws into his tender hide. But then he couldn't roll his chair over my tail fur and leave me bald, either. Our relationship worked, except when I had guests. A knock on the door sent Mr. Hyde skidding across the tile floor into the closet, passing through the closed doors as if by magic. My friends thought I had lost my mind, leaving out food and water for a phantom cat. I could never coax Mr. Hyde out of the closet, and the bulbs kept blowing out when I opened the closet door to prove he was down in the corner behind a box of Christmas decorations. I suppose it was no weirder than some of my friends' pets or relationships. Then the time came for me to move again. You'll love Dallas, my boyfriend said over the phone, and I know you love me. I don't want to move to Texas, I said, glancing out the window at the trees and the little green shoots showing between patches of melting snow. I'd planted crocuses and tulips the fall before, and soon the roses would be in full bloom. It doesn't snow down there, and it's hot and dusty. We get snow, occasionally. He sighed. Don't you want to marry me? I did, but... Yes. All right then. How soon can you get here? A month. That's too long. I miss you. A month. I need to make arrangements, get some things into storage, pack, and... I looked around. There wouldn't be a fireplace in the bedroom in Dallas. A month. How would I get Mr. Hyde out of the closet? I didn't want to leave him behind. I handed the keys to Philip. Well, that's it. You know how to work the propane heater, and the plumber will be by to fix the sink tomorrow. The truck should be here at about 4 o'clock to pick up the bookcases. I picked up the box of light bulbs and handed them to Philip. You'll need these, too. Why would I need that many light bulbs? For the hall light near the closet. Philip chuckled. Oh, the phantom cat. He likes tender victuals, and make sure to wash his bowls every time you feed him. No one has seen your cat. And yet the food keeps disappearing. I took his arm and led him to the closet, carrying the step stool with me. Opening the step stool and centering it under the ceiling light, I held out a bulb. Go on. Open the door and look inside. Philip reached for the door. Be careful, or it will... quote. The door fell on his head. It does that sometimes. Philip rubbed his forehead. Thanks for telling me. Anything else I should know? He propped the door up against the wall. You'll see. Will it hurt? I gestured to the closet. See for yourself. Philip opened the door and looked where I pointed. Hey, he said, there's something in there. He'd spotted the glowing amber eyes in the darkest shadow in the corner. It's a cat. The hall light went out. That's Mr. Hyde. He goes with the apartment. I don't want a cat. Placing the light bulb in his hand and urging him to climb the stool, I nodded. He'll get used to you. He handed me the burned-out bulb, and I tossed it into the trash on my way out the door. One more thing, Philip. Never sit with your back exposed. Why? You'll figure it out.